I started buttoning. That's what I did. Yes, I buttoned the records when the records started getting to the end. I'd cut it and I'd do my version. And then it goes a little. And also, I played Dylan and Beatles and Stones and, you know, and you're supposed to play white people. Not at this radio station. That's what they said. And I said, okay. And then I put my, play what I want to play anyway. And then people, they seemed to like, they liked it. So, as a matter of fact, I couldn't get fired.
I was listening to a different radio station before I knew that Sylvester Stewart was Sly Stone. So I just accidentally hit it, and I was like, it was this great commercial. It was an X-Lax commercial, and I thought, oh, great. And then I heard a toilet flush, and I went, whoa! You know, that was not happening. I would never expect to hear that in a commercial. And so I started listening only when he was on the show, and then I turned back to KDIA and listened to my folks' music, and which I was drawn to, and then I found out that Sylvester Stewart called himself Sly Stone on the radio, so I was all excited and I wanted to go say hello because I thought he'd remember me from Sacramento, and he sure did. Yeah. He remembered me.
Joking one time, I said, "Why don't you sing your whole program tonight?" He sure as heck did. He sang the news, he sang the weather, he sang everything, his entire show. Nobody's ever done that.
Yeah, but he also just said, hey man, you know what? You gotta quit the radio and get the band and do a band. And so I said, okay.
Yeah, I was the nudge. I said, man, please, man. So you're a great disc jockey, but imagine what a great band leader it would be with us playing. And it happened. And it changed all of our lives and millions of other people.